The first overtime game in SDSU football history is also one of the most memorable ever played on homecoming. The 1998 Hobo Day Tilt with Omaha is this week's Jackrabbit Legend, presented by Legend Seeds, your regional seed leader. After starting 1-2, the Jacks were aiming for their third straight win on an overcast, windy Hobo Day in October of 1998. They opposition the 11th-ranked Mavericks of Nebraska-Omaha. Brock Barron started things in a big way. Less than 6 minutes into the game, the Jackrabbit wideout took a punt and ran it back 56 yards for a touchdown. 7-0 Jacks. Omaha would score a field goal, but that would be it for a physical first half, and SDSU led 7-3 at the break. The Mavericks jumped ahead on a 25-yard touchdown run, but Brett Gorden's 42-yard field goal at the end of the third quarter tied the game at 10. And just a few minutes later, the Jacks went back in front. Andy Rennerfelt looked deep for his All-American tight end, and Steve Heiden did the rest. But that was just the beginning of a wild back-and-forth final period. Omaha would tie it on a short run. Yankton native Scott Nedved pushed State back in front with an 18-yard scamper. 90 seconds later, the Mavericks again tied it, and we were destined for overtime. In the extra period, the Jacks had the ball first, and Gorden connected from 39 yards. The Mavericks also settled for a field goal, and with the score even at 27, it was time for a second OT. The game featured 12 punts and only 300 yards of total passing, so it was fitting a field goal would decide it. In the top of the second overtime, SDSU held the Mavericks scoreless, and in the bottom, freshman running back Josh Ronick, who ran for over 100 yards in the sixth straight game, 167 on 33 attempts, set up Brett Gorden, and he connected again. This time, Gordon's 23-yarder split the uprights to send SDSU's fans home happy. Jacks 30, Omaha 27 in double overtime, October 17, 1998. A Jackrabbit legend.